Well, what we saw over the past week and the final game between AlphaGo and Lee Sedol is a big deal for humanity with lots of implications that stretch far beyond a board game. The final match between the first official match, in fact, of man versus machine may be over, but the bigger contest is by no means over. In the studio with me to provide us some perspective is Chung Tae-myung. Professor Chung is head of software development at Sungkyunkwan University. Professor Chung, welcome to the program.
Hi.
Now, I'm sure you watched the match between AlphaGo and human champion Lee Sedol. I'd like to know, before we get into anything else, your overall thoughts.
It was a very interesting game, first of all. Then to say precisely, it was not just the Go game between the Lee Sedol and AlphaGo. Actually, it was the match between the human and the computer. Since AlphaGo used more than 1,200 CPUs, which means brain, and unlimited memory space, while Lee Sedol used just one single brain and limited memory. Also, AlphaGo probably used not only the learned patterns, but also the search all the possible cases. It was quite possible because AlphaGo can search more than 10 million different cases within two given minutes.
When you say deep learning, I know that this does not mean it's just based on massive data. Deep learning is learning the machines learning the way humans think. So is the ultimate goal of AI to mimic the human brain, to say?
The deep learning, the AI technology, is not the only technique to apply to solve some problems. We are using the parallel computing, we are using the data sciences to analyze the data, and also learning things from the old previous patterns. They are all integrated in one algorithm and given to the computer. Then computer can apply it to the games to solve the problems. Then this whole thing is to mimic the human brain and human way of thinking.
So if a robot could, through artificial intelligence, could really, I suppose, gain the intelligence of the human brain, what about emotions? Can we build a robot with emotions, of sense of identity even?
As a computer scientist, I think it's possible. Think about the color. How can we implement the color into the computer? We digitalize the color into the computer and sounds too. So if we can digitalize the emotion and sense of identity, why not? We can have the computer this emotion and the sense of identity. So which means that the digitalization is the key word in this sense.
Right, digitalization. So we know that Google's been obviously investing in the sector of artificial intelligence for some time. We know that Apple is also China's Baidu. So a lot, major names have been investing in the research and development of artificial intelligence. I'd like to know how far along Korea is.
Google invested about $30 billion for AI since 2001. Then moreover, the result of their R&D already applied to in real human life. For example, the cognitive, the computing solution at IBM, the Watson, it already applied in various app services. They are deployed in the hospitals. They participate in the examining the cancers. So they go ahead. Compared to them, we have a long way to go. I think we are still in the stage of studying artificial intelligence in academia.
All right, Chung Tae-myung, professor of software development at Sungkyunkwan University. Thank you so much for being with us tonight.
Thank you.